All right, welcome back. We're going to start the last lesson of chapter 11, which is all about spheres. And so today is an introduction. We've seen volume of spheres before, but we're going to get more into it today. But there's some vocabulary we need to be aware of when we're talking about a sphere. So sphere is that three-dimensional like ball. Okay, and that ball has a diameter, it has a radius, but it has some other features as well. So we're going to start with some of the basics. The center of the sphere has that same name, that is the center. Okay, the radius of the sphere is from the center to the outside point of any edge of that circle. And so that is what we call the radius. Okay, now the radius, when we double that, goes through the center, but it's from end to end. In this picture, I've drawn that this way. This is our diameter. But there's a new word that we are going to use here. And that's what we call a great circle. So the outside edge of the sphere, the outside edge of the sphere, if I go around and around, so think about like latitude or longitude in geography and on a globe. If I look at the greatest cross-section area possible, this is what we call a great circle. Okay. And this can go in any direction. And I remember it as the largest cross section of a sphere. Okay. And again, I mentioned it, but you can write it here. You can think latitude and longitude, but most specifically, this is the equator. Okay, I think I misspelled that. But anyways, these are some of the vocabulary pieces that are associated with a sphere. Now, yesterday or in our previous video, we looked at the volume and surface area of a sphere. So as a quick reminder, the formula for volume of a sphere is 4/3 pi times the radius cubed. And the surface area is 4 pi radius squared. Okay, so remember, area is always squared, volume is always cubed. Now, that's different for when we're dealing with a hemisphere or half a sphere. Okay, well, volume is actually kind of straightforward. What's half of 4/3? That would be 2/3. So the volume formula for a hemisphere is 2/3 times pi times the radius cubed. That's not quite as straightforward for surface area, because surface area has the base, which is a circle, and then half of the volume. Half the surface area of a sphere. Well, if the base is pi r squared, and then half of the surface area of a sphere is 2 pi r squared, then the surface area of a hemisphere is actually pi r 3 times pi r squared. Okay, so we've got two ways to think about it, or if you're just looking for something to memorize, this is what you'd memorize. So with that in mind, we actually did a little bit of this yesterday with volume, with surface area, but now we're going to find volume and surface area of each sphere. We're asked to give the exact value and approximate solutions, this time rounded to the nearest tenth. Okay, so What I would like for you to do is pause. You have the two formulas here for volume and surface area. I've given you the specifics. Be careful on this one. Take a couple of minutes. Find the volume and surface area, both exact and approximate, for each, and then come back and let's check. All right. So here's our first example using the appropriate formulas. One of the things that caught my attention with this problem is the fact that I end up with what seems like exact same answers, but these are not the same. What makes them different? Well, it's their units. Just because we have the same numerical answers does not mean we have identical answers, because the units are different. For volume, that is a cubic unit. For surface area, that is a square unit. These are nowhere near the same values because of the units. So that's something to keep in mind. Another thing to keep in mind might be, oh, well, this must be true for all spheres. And that would be a false assumption, because as we work out that next example, identifying that we're given a diameter, so the radius is going to be half that. Here's an example where our previous assumption proves to be false. Okay, so I set up my formulas, I simplify, I see, hey, I get totally different numbers now, which just goes to prove not all spheres have the same volume and surface area numerical values. Some do, and that's kind of cool when that happens, but most of the time it is different. And again, the units make all the difference here as well. So volume is always a cubic unit, surface area is always a squared unit. All right, we're going to wrap up this lesson by looking at a composition. Okay, more than that, this is going to pull in some science terms as well. So you are given a right cylinder with a hemispheric top. Okay. Now, we're told that the density of this figure is 100 kilograms per cubic meter, and we're asked for the mass. So the first thing we have to ask ourselves is, well, what is mass? Okay, so even though it's not given to me here, I might have to do a little bit of Googling if I don't remember that. But mass is going to be density times the volume. Okay, well, if I'm given the density, that means I need to find the volume in order to be able to find the mass. So that's my first step. Find out how to calculate the mass. Then the second step, is to calculate the volume of the solid. Okay, now I like this problem because it's a composition of solids. So I'm gonna have to find the volume of the hemisphere and add that to the volume of the cylinder. So I'm gonna have to pull out some of those formulas. Okay, so the volume of a hemisphere is going to be pi. In my notes, I had these switched. So I was looking and I got those mixed up. The volume of a hemisphere is 2/3 times pi r cubed. And the volume of the cylinder is pi r squared times h. Okay, well, I'm going to leave pi alone. We'll only round at the end. But to find radius, my figure says I'm given the diameter of 2 meters, so my radius must be 1 meter. So that's 1 cubed, and then 1 squared times my height is 3. That's supposed to be a plus. I am just all over the place today. All right, so with that, this is actually pretty straightforward to simplify. 1 cubed is 1, 1 times pi is pi. So this is 2/3 pi plus 3 pi. Okay. And then if I want to give an exact answer, I need common denominators. So 3 pi, I'm going to turn into 9 pi over 3. So that I can add those together, and that gives me 11/3 pi. Now this is my volume, so that's a cubic meter. And this is an exact answer for the volume of the solid. Now I'm going to keep this exact and only round at the very end if I need to. So now that I know the volume of my solid, I'm going to plug that in with the information about density to find the mass. So my last step, the mass is the density, and that was 100 kilograms per cubic meter, times the volume, which was 11/3 pi meters cubed. Now I'm throwing in my units here because if we notice this factor, we divide by cubic meters, and this factor is cubic meters. So cubic meters divided by cubic meters, those units are going to cancel each other out. So all I'm left with is kilograms for the mass. Okay. So 100 times 11/3, that is 11/3 pi kilograms. This is, again, our exact, okay? But this is what we would round here at the end. So if I take 1100 divided by 3 times pi, I get approximately 1,151.92 kilograms as the mass of this solid. Okay, so that was probably a little bit more advanced example than what we're going to ask you guys to do on a test, but the ideas for what we covered here are cross-curricular, using science along with some geometric ideas to answer questions about three-dimensional solid figures. So with that, you've got a couple of problems in your homework. Please make sure that you're showing all of your work. Answers only are not appropriate. And then submit your homework into turnitin.com. I'll see you guys next time.